Hi, this is Dr. Rahul Pandya. Welcome to our channel. A general structure of a review paper is comprised of the following. A title indicates the impactful insight of the article so that the readers can decide whether the article is relevant to their research or not. The abstract should represent a complete projection of the research problem that we are reviewing. It should be crisp, impactful, and present the brief of our contributions. The introduction starts with a brief introduction on the existing research trend focused on a specific problem. It emphasizes why the current research topic is essential, the current state of the art, and the research gaps that can be pursued in the future. Furthermore, it should clearly mention the opportunities, limitations, and challenges. Subsequently, give a quick summary of the structure of the organization of the rest of the paper. The following section could be comprehensive review methods, where a structured summary of the existing literatures, methods, protocols, strategies, algorithms, synthesis, etc. can be presented in detail. This can contain multiple sections constituting figures, comprehensive summary tables, charts, diagrams, etc. Give a detailed summary of the outcomes along with the analytical discussions. Highlight the existing research gaps and future scope. Under the conclusion section, indicate the key findings. In the acknowledgement section, we can acknowledge the funding agency or anyone who supported during the presented work. In the end, present the list of references which we referred during the review. In general, a comprehensive review paper contains 200 to 300 references. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much.